Alamo Industrial boom mowers and cutting heads are designed to deliver top performance on the job. With that performance comes top-notch power, and every operator should be prepared to reach high into treetops, over obstacles, and down into embankments with knowledge and confidence. Hello, I'm Cynthia Lee for Alamo Industrial. Dealing with top-of-the-line equipment takes a top-of-the-line attitude when it comes to safety and operation. At Alamo Industrial, your safety and performance on the job is our number one priority. Part of being safe is to fully understand how to operate and maintain your machine in a hazard-free environment. Keeping you secure and productive around our equipment is our mission. However, it is your responsibility as the operator to read and understand the operator's manuals provided by Alamo Industrial and the tractor manufacturer in their entirety before operating any machine. This video is a supplement to the manual and is divided into four sections, including personal safety, inspection, operation, and maintenance. As an operator working with some of the most powerful cutting machines in the field, you must be fully aware of the potential hazards associated with this type of equipment. Some of the potential hazards described in the operator's manual include objects being thrown up to 300 feet, the potential for severed limbs, and electrocution from contact with power lines. Prepare yourself to avoid these and other hazardous situations by thoroughly understanding the intended use of your product, as well as the safety warnings and instructions associated with it. This is a safety alert symbol which calls your attention to the possibility of personal injury or death. It is located and explained within the detailed listing of all decals on your machine in the safety section of the manual. It is important that you become familiar with all warning decals and understand what they mean. Make sure each decal is clean and visible on the mower at all times during operation or maintenance. Alamo Industrial will provide replacements at no cost to you for damaged or aged decals. Let's address your personal protective equipment, or PPE. You should have the following items: a hard hat, protective eyewear with side shields and ear protection. You should also wear a reflective safety vest, work gloves, and safety shoes. All clothing should be fitted properly, and work shirts should be tucked in to avoid entanglements. An operator must be alert and physically capable of running the equipment before starting the job. For example, some drugs can impair your ability to operate the machinery safely without incident. If you have a question regarding the effects of prescription or over-the-counter medication, talk to your doctor before operating the machine. Alcohol should never be used before or during equipment operation. Before starting any job, a thorough equipment inspection must be performed. This is done by a walk-around process. The tractor should not be running, and the cutting head should be securely in the boom rest or on the ground during this time. You should use the daily inspection sheet located within your operator's manual as a guide. Be sure to log your work during each inspection. Inspection sheets may also be downloaded at www.alamo-industrial.com. The first step is to inspect the warning lights and signs. All lights should be clean and functional. Check the slow-moving vehicle emblem, reflectors, and safety signs to make sure they're in good condition, secure, and visible. If not, they should be replaced. Next, check the tractor tires. Look for visible wear and test for recommended inflation. Also, make sure the lug nuts are tight and secure. It is very important to visually inspect the entire hydraulic system. If you suspect a leak due to oil accumulation or pooling, try to identify the hose or hoses that may be leaking. Notify your maintenance person to replace the hose. Do not operate this equipment with hydraulic oil or fuel leaking. Oil and fuel are combustible and could be a fire hazard. If you must pressurize the system to find a suspected leak, never, under any circumstance, use your bare hand. Put on safety glasses and oil impervious gloves and use a piece of wood or cardboard for leak detection. High pressure fluid can be invisible and injected into the body through the skin, causing serious injury or death. If injection should happen, a doctor familiar with this type of injury must surgically remove the injected fluid immediately. After checking the hydraulic system, inspect the cutting head for wear or damage. There are a variety of mowing heads for each boom mower. However, all fit general inspection guidelines. Inspect the mower blades, blade bolts, and knives for excessive wear or damage. Look for bent blades, cracks in the steel, elongated holes, and missing parts. Rotary blades should be free swinging, and the blade bolt torque should also be set properly. Torque specifications are found in the operator's manual. Blades, blade bolts, and knives must be replaced at the same time to maintain balance, safety, and performance. Under no circumstance should you ever try to hard face, repair, weld, or straighten a blade. Always replace worn or damaged blades and hardware with Alamo Industrial replacement parts. Using anything other than genuine OEM parts questions safety integrity and voids all warranty coverage on your mower. While reviewing the cutting head, begin checking for proper lubrication in the top of the head and in all boom pivot joints as outlined in your manual. Inadequate lubrication may result in the premature failure of the mower. Ask a maintenance person to assist you with this process if necessary. Safety shielding is your next priority. All mowers come with some type of front and rear safety shielding, primarily in the form of either rubber deflectors or chain guards. Keep in mind, debris may be thrown over 300 feet, the length of a football field, so it is imperative that all shielding is in place and functional. If items are missing or damaged, replace them with OEM parts before operating the mower. Finally, you'll want to ensure that all tractor windows are clean and the windshield wipers are in good working condition. Visibility is vital for operational safety and performance. Before you can operate the mower safely and efficiently, you must first become familiar with the tractor. Now keep in mind, all tractors are different. It's important you understand your unique controls and environment for both transport and mowing. Start by making a safe entrance into the tractor by using the specially designed steps and handrails. Never use control levers for support. Fasten your seatbelt. Adjust all mirrors, including the external ones. Then check your visibility. All tractors have blind spots. Know where they are. Before transporting, it is very important to measure the height of the boom. Ensure the highest point is within limits of bridge and overpass heights of roadways to be used during transport. If you are transporting the boom on a trailer, place the mower in the boom rest and measure the height. If it exceeds the limits, place the mower head on deck and remeasure before you begin moving. Do not transport the unit if the measured height exceeds 13 feet 6 inches. As you drive to the job site, you should make sure the mower is properly seated in its boom rest and the master switch is in the off position. This will prevent the boom from being engaged. Your SMV sign should be secure and visible. Your tractor hazard lights should also be on at all times when the unit is moving. Before you begin mowing, you must inspect the area around you. The tractor and mower should be off and stowed before you exit the cab. Notice the location of power lines, telephone junction boxes, utility cables, and gas lines. Do not allow the mower head to come within 10 feet of these items at any time. Also look for tree stumps and debris like concrete, garbage, or fallen tree trunks. Wire, cable, and chain can be especially dangerous as they can get wrapped around the blades and blade bar. The ends of the strands can contact the mower deck and be broken off, then thrown out from under the mower in all directions including toward the operator. If you can, pick these items up and put them in a collection area. If you can't move them, make sure you know where they are as you mow so they may be avoided. Never, under any circumstance, should you mow when people are within 300 feet of your job site. Understanding the mower controls is significant to your performance. There are two different control options for Alamo Industrial boom mowers, the cable control and the joystick control. Both have a decal showing the operation. We'll focus on the joystick control first. You must turn on the master control switch to engage the joystick, which operates similar to a video game joystick. The decal displays the following functionality. Movement backward and forward operates the main boom up and down. Movement from side to side moves the dipper section in and out. Twisting the joystick operates the swing motion forward to back. Thumb switches engage the head tilt and hydraulic door on the rotary head. Boomax rotaries include only manually adjustable doors. A trigger and push button operate head swivels should your product incorporate that option. With the cable control, a series of levers operates the boom with the same functions as the joystick. A push-pull switch engages the controls. Again, a decal shows actual movement. Now that the site has been inspected and you know the controls, you are ready to begin mowing. First, position the rotary head about 6 to 12 inches off of the ground. For the flail and other heads, set the cutter near the ground. Next, with the tractor at idle, engage the mower by using the switch on the control box. Then, bring the speed up to your tractor 540 PTO speed indicated on the gauge. If it is your first time powering up the unit for operation, move through the controls a couple of times to ensure all of the air is out of the hydraulic lines. After verifying again to make sure the site is safe, put the tractor in low gear and begin mowing. It is important while you mow to control the stability of the tractor and boom mower, especially on slopes. If the unit is operated on slopes greater than 5 degrees, additional counterweight is required. Operation on slopes greater than 11 degrees is not recommended under any circumstances. Know the limits of the tractor and soil. Make sure the ground is solid below the tires before extending the boom. Test the soil, and if you feel it could give under the weight of the tractor tire, do not extend the boom. If the boom is extended and you feel unstable, slowly lower the head to the ground, then draw it into the tractor until you can safely raise it again. If the tractor does tip to the right, the boom and head will act as an outrigger and will normally prevent rollovers. If this happens, stay in the operator's seat with your seatbelt securely fastened. Power the unit down, set the parking brake, and phone for help. Do not move without assistance. Always follow the mowing safety tips listed on the decal located in your operator's packet while operating your machine. Some additional safety and performance tips to note include: all mowing heads are designed to cut trees and tree limbs in the vertical position. Only grass should be cut with the head horizontal to the ground. Never place the head directly over trees or limbs and push down, as this will cause damage to blades and blade bolts and maximize the potential for thrown objects as well as machine failure. Trim trees and limbs starting closest to the ground and move up with each cutting path. Always mow forward into vegetation, never backwards. Limbs should be cut in approximately 4-foot lengths at a time, moving in with each cut to prevent debris from falling on the tractor cab. Drive forward to engage the material with minor boom maneuvering. Stopping the tractor and moving the boom only is not recommended for continuous cutting and will cause premature wear and tear on your unit. When you've finished mowing, bring the tractor to a complete stop. Place the transmission in the park position and reduce the engine speed. Turn the mower switch off and wait for the rotating parts to stop. Place the mower head in the transport position within the boom rest, then return safely to your storage area. Your Alamo Industrial boom mower must be properly maintained, not only for your safety, but also for maximum performance. Work should be performed by an experienced maintenance professional. However, as the operator who inspects the mower routinely, you have the responsibility to inform the maintenance personnel when issues need to be addressed. Maintenance practices are detailed in your operator's manual. It's important that you become familiar with and follow this routine for optimal performance. In the maintenance schedule, you will be addressing the following areas: the hydraulic system. Be sure to look for damage in the fittings and hoses, such as pinching, kinking, twisting, and damage on the outer cover of the system, as well as leaks. Again, use a piece of paper or cardboard to check for leaks. Never use your hand. If there is a leak or damage, tighten fittings or replace hoses immediately. The reservoir should be filled to 3/4 full on the sight glass on the side of the tank. Do not overfill. Check the hydraulic filter gauge on a weekly basis. Before adding any hydraulic oil, thoroughly clean the cap and surrounding area. Add the oil using only a filter pump system or a pre-filtered oil. Contamination can quickly lead to costly hydraulic system failure. Proper lubrication. All pivot points should be checked for proper lubrication. These points can be on the end of each cylinder, boom hinge points, etc. Refer to your manual for specific locations. Inject the recommended grease into the Zerks on all points. Blade and hardware integrity. Inspect for cracks or damage to the blades or blade bolts. On the flail, look for missing knives. Change all blades and knives out in sets to ensure balance. On flail heads, also check for proper belt fit. Be sure and reinstall the safety shielding after each check. You should retorque all bolts and fasteners according to torque specifications in the manual every 8 hours unless otherwise specified. It is vital that you retorque all mainframe and deck bolts after the first 8 hours of operation. For booms with slewing ring bearings, the bearings should be greased daily. Swing the boom to the forwardmost position and inject the grease in the three fittings on the outside edge of the bearing. Swing the boom straight out from the tractor and grease. Then swing to the furthest rear position and grease again. Safety shielding and structural integrity. Replace worn or damaged safety shielding such as rubber deflectors and chain guards. You should also inspect the operator protection screen for damage. On most cab units, this will be the polycarbonate or Lexan in the door and side window, and on ROPS units, it will be the expanded metal cage. Note, open station tractors are not recommended for use with boom mowers. Also, routinely review the entire machine for cracking or weld failure due to normal wear. Address any issues immediately with your supervisor. Properly inspecting, operating, and maintaining your Alamo Industrial boom mower is key when it comes to safety. Remember, you must read the operator's manual in its entirety before you begin mowing, and don't hesitate to ask questions. I'm Cynthia Lee for Alamo Industrial, reminding you to always stay on the cutting edge of mower safety. Thank you for watching, and have a safe and productive day.